NATO is pushing Canada to bolster its northern defences in a bid to compete with and counter Russia and China's Arctic ambitions. Both nations have been eyeing off critical sea routes in the Arctic, prompting Prime Minister Justin Trudeau to launch a new defence strategy with a stronger focus on the north. But as our Washington correspondent Annalise Nielsen explains, Canada's plan still falls short of its NATO commitment.
Few people will ever travel to the North Pole. Fewer still will ever parachute in. These three Russians who jumped from the Earth's stratosphere to plunge 10 kilometres down to some of the harshest terrain on Earth weren't just there to break a world record. They were there to show off some of Russia's technological strength in the Arctic Circle.
We should note that all of the systems, the oxygen supply, heating, special equipment, it was all Russian made and it all did just a great job and we established a world record.
Canada is now on the front line of an increasingly tense fight for dominance in the Arctic. And its NATO allies pushing Canada to do more. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau launched Canada's new defence strategy with Arctic defence front and centre.
Rising and disruptive powers like China and Russia mean NATO's northern and western flank is the Canadian Arctic.
From their northern outposts, the Canadian Armed Forces will bolster military surveillance and combat capabilities in the Arctic. The announcement comes with a significant increase in defence spending for Canada to $8.1 billion Canadian dollars in the next 5 years, $73 billion over the next 20. But even with this increase in spending, Canada is still falling short of the NATO commitment to spend 2% of GDP on defence.
NATO is an Arctic alliance. Canada plays a very important part in that.
The harsh, sparsely populated terrain of northwest Canada might not seem like much of a border risk. Even the most nefarious actors would struggle to access Canada through this part of the world. But the fact there are so few people living here is exactly why it's so difficult to protect. And if there was a rise in global tensions, the trade routes to the north of here become extremely valuable.
The Northwest Passage could become the most efficient shipping route between Europe and Asia by 2050. That's just 26 years away. Canadians are, once again, called upon to meet the moment.
Recent tensions in the Red Sea showed just how quickly trade routes can be disrupted and how damaging the flow-on effects can be right around the world. The Arctic Circle is no different in its value. Annalise Nielsen, Sky News in Yellowknife, Canada.